Myanmar junta foes form unity government. This is an article by Reuters. Ousted MPs, ethnic groups, and protest leaders join hands to seek international support. And here, a video released by this CRPH. This is the parallel government set up by the US-backed opposition in Myanmar. This is the government that the US is eventually going to try to push everyone to recognize instead of the military-led government. And this is Min Ko Naing, a prominent pro-democracy leader in an undisclosed location, as he announces the formation of a national unity government, including different ethnic groups, amid a crackdown on protests against the military coup. And who is this guy? Because to me, his name is very familiar, and I'll tell you why his name is very familiar. This is an article by the Irrawaddy. This is a US government-funded propaganda operation inside Myanmar. It's funded by the National Endowment for Democracy. And it says right here, 88 generation peace and open society stand by government on Rakhine. This is from 2017. Rakhine State is where the Rohingya are and where they have been brutalized for years, mainly by Aung San Suu Kyi's followers and supporters. And the Western media has tried to cover this up for years by shifting all of the blame entirely on Myanmar's military and whitewashing the opposition's role in all of this, but they can't hide it anymore. So in this 2017 article, here we have prominent 88 generation leader Min Ko Naing said that the state's problems were not racial or religious, but to do with immigration laws and terrorism, because they're claiming the Rohingya are invaders and they're terrorists. That's why he says it that way. They, self-identifying Rohingya, are not one of the 135 ethnic groups in Myanmar, he said. This is what racist extremists all around the globe say. They say, this group doesn't belong in our country. They're invaders. They came here and we need to throw them back out, back to their where they came from. That's what he's saying. That's what this so-called pro-democracy, liberal, progressive hero that the West keeps claiming he is, that's what he's saying about the Rohingya. Min Ko Naing warned of violence elsewhere in the country, threatening stability, but said the 88 generation would not resort to violence. He warned of possible instigation of violence elsewhere in the country. He said 88 generation peace and open society does not accept this behavior, but would not use violence to stop it. But of course, that's what he says publicly. The people in these groups are the ones going into the Rohingya villages, chopping people up with machetes, burning homes and businesses to the ground. These are the people who are doing it. And if you read the Western media's reports very carefully, you'll notice a lot of times there is this ethnic strife, and that it's the police and the military that come in and have to break it up. Here's another article from Frontier Myanmar. Again, this is another Western-backed, supported, propped up media operation inside Myanmar. Activists championed by rights groups have history of anti-Rohingya messaging. Of course they do. And if we go here, they mention him again. Min Ko Naing justified the expulsion of the Rohingya by claiming they are not one of the recognized ethnic groups in Myanmar. And as I've said many, many times before, if you look at the map of Myanmar, here's Bangladesh, there is the border, this is Rakhine State. Here, if you've ever traveled anywhere and you've gone close to any border anywhere, you will know that that is a place where people mix. Over generations, people have crossed back and forth over the border. The border itself has moved forward and backwards over time. You're going to have people from Bangladesh on the Myanmar side and vice versa. They're not invaders. They've been there for generations. They are an ethnic group that is part of Myanmar's fabric. Whether racists like Min Ko Naing, this now pro-democracy leader, that's what we're being told he is now by the West, whether he says they are or not, they are definitely part of Myanmar's ethnic minority groups. I'm pointing this out. It's very important that people understand that this is not a pro-democracy movement. This is a group driven by racial supremacy. If they get back into power, they're going to go right back to killing the Rohingya, just like they were doing when Aung San Suu Kyi took power. And they're going to turn on all of the other ethnic groups that are actually even supporting them now. We saw the exact same thing in Libya. All of those groups got stitched together by the US. It was an artificial coalition. And as soon as the job was done of dividing and destroying Libya, all of those groups turned on each other, and they have been killing each other ever since. That is exactly what's headed for Myanmar in the near future, if this doesn't stop. And I've said it in previous videos, and I'm going to say it again. The goal here is to turn Myanmar into a failed state, a dead weight, not only around China's neck for the next decade or so, but also around the rest of Asia's neck. This is to stop Asia's rise and to preserve America's hegemony over this region, even though the US isn't even located in Asia. If you thought this video was useful, please like and share it. Think about subscribing. It helps the channel grow, and it's free to do. Look in the video description for all of these links, as well as for ways you can help support my work so that I can continue making videos like this. And as always, thank you for watching.